Thanks everyone. We are starting our program, and this is not a very big gathering, but still it's a start. Thanks for being here so early in the morning. We have here with us Jai Bharti. Everybody knows her. She is an eminent biker and she has walked a lot with Ministry of Tourism. She has done this beautiful expedition, Road to Mekong, which has got a lot of publicity. And we also want to congratulate her because of this recent grant you have received, which is also getting accolades all over India. I would request Telangana Tourism also to come and participate. And I would like to welcome Smita. Smita S. Kumar of Archaeological Survey of India. She is the superintendent archaeologist. She has been transferred here very recently. And then we are hoping many great things from Smita. She has already started cooperating with us, and Golconda Fort, it is such a landmark gem of Hyderabad city. And we are here to celebrate this gem. We are here to make promotions. And then here with us, we have Mr. Srinivas with us today. He is the district transport officer of Telangana Police, and we welcome here, sir, because we need your guidance, your help to guide our riders, because they will be on the road and you can speak to them what to do, what not to do, how to ride safely and how to ride responsibly. And we have Telangana Tourism over here. They are going to speak about TSTDC properties all over Telangana, which bikers can use and which bikers can promote in their social media handles. And we last but not the least, we have Anand from Revio Soul. Revio Soul is a biking app which connects the bikers who wants to go on a road trip. Before this, we did not have this kind of help. The bikers had to organize themselves for a trip. But with the help of technology is a beautiful thing, and we are happy that Anand is taking the advantage of such technology and trying to unite the bikers on road trips, trying to cooperate. So that is what we are here today, and I am Shatrupa Datta, Assistant Director, India Tourism Hyderabad Office from Ministry of Tourism, Government of India. Let me tell you a little bit about Dekho Apna Desh. You can see in your backdrop, this is Dekho Apna Desh. Dekho Apna Desh means domestic tourism. We go far and away, but we forget to look what is in our backyard. Many Hyderabadis I have come across, they have not seen Golconda Fort itself properly. Maybe they come here for a picnic, but when I ask them, have you had a guided tour of Golconda? Do you know the story? How Golconda is a Persian dream? They say, no, we have no idea. So that is what we are trying to promote. When you look at something, you must know the story of it. You must know the history of it, its heritage, and how you are connected to it. So that is Dekho Apna Desh. We are asking everyone to start traveling. And after this pandemic, it is a little bit normal now. So everybody has started traveling to survive, to restart, and giving everybody that encouragement to travel again. That is our motto, to travel again. You start traveling, you do it slowly, take it up, and then take adventure tourism forward. Because when you are in a biking trip, you are in an open space. The risk of disease is less in an open space. You are using your own vehicle. So you'll be using the campsites. So these are the things we want to promote, and we'll be very happy if you can take it forward in your social media handles. Our social media tags will be @IncredibleIndia, @MinistryofTourismGovernmentofIndia, Twitter will be @IndiaTourismH. All these things we'll be sharing with you, and whatever your story is, your photograph, your story, you tag us, we'll promote it in our social media, and in this way together we will take it up. Thank you so much. I'll ask Jai Bharti if she can give a little bit of encouragement.
Thank you, Shatrupadri. Thank you everyone for assembling here, the guests on the dais, and everybody who has come here. Of course, because of COVID protocols, the rally did not happen, but we thought let us at least start whatever we have begun. Like Shatrupa madam has said, most of us as bikers are already exploring many places in our own backyard in India. But unfortunately, we forget to promote our own tourism. We are going there, we are taking selfies, we are taking photos, we are these days doing lot of vlogs. But we forget to tag India and India tourism or the respective state tourism. In most of the countries, people try to go, be it whether it is Thailand or US or Europe, people go just because that craze has been created, just like one small festival of the Tomatino festival in Spain. Just because that hashtag is created and promotions are done, people travel from all across the world to go there. We have many beautiful places in India itself, but the only thing is we are not able to promote. Of course, we do not have enough resources like other countries to promote tourism in a big way, but we as citizens of India do have a responsibility to promote our own country and showcase it to the world in a better way, and with our photographs we can definitely do that. I think in my experience we have promoted tourism in a big way and the outreach has been really good, so I request all my biker friends here to continue promoting our own country's tourism through our trips and especially through our social media space what each of us have. And thank you ASI for allowing us to do this small event here. This is the first time I think as bikers we have a small platform at the Golconda Fort, and I'm sure slowly this will continue and encourage most of us to do things hands in hands with the tourism departments, because what we do right now is just for our own happiness or, you know, for the love for travel, but we have never associated much with tourism to do things like this. So I'm sure we will try to do more, and these kind of programs will encourage us to continue supporting with the tourism department. It's a vice versa. We will be there whenever you want to do some events, and when we want to do something also we will take your help, and we will try to promote tourism in a big way. Thank you Srinivas sir for coming here in a short with a short notice. As we all know, Srinivas sir is one person in Telangana who has been promoting road safety from so many years. He believes a lot in road safety, and he runs something called Rasta Roads Are Safe For All. He has written a book published by the Telangana government, because most of us don't even know the rules we need to follow once we are on the road as cyclists, motorcyclists, or car drivers, lorry drivers, or even the pedestrians. So he has been doing incredible amount of work in creating awareness through his social media and through other whatever various ways of communications he can beyond his official status. So we appreciate that a lot, sir. And in every of our trips or in every of our programs, we would like to take your guidance so that you can encourage many of us to get on to safe riding. Anand, I'm glad that we came up with this Rev Your Soul app, because as bikers we all know that we would want to travel together wherever we are going, but sometimes our friends might not be free to join us on our trips. But we can get onto these kind of apps and look out for others, or maybe there are new riders who need somebody else to guide them or take them to these kind of places. So these kind of apps in the world of technology, like Shatrupaji has said, create a lot of opportunity for us to ride safe and also promote our tourism in a big way. So I request all of you to also download this app and see what best we can do to support these kind of initiatives. And thank you Telangana Tourism, they have always been our backbone, they have always been supporting whatever we have done within Telangana, outside Telangana, and we hope to get your continuous support in all our initiatives. Thank you.
Thank you, Jai Bhartiji. That was very encouraging, and we are going to do a Facebook Live also. So many people who are on our page, so they will be listening to these encouraging words and will be coming up with more ideas of road trips. Can I ask Smita ji to say a few words about this beautiful monument we are here today? We really are privileged to be here, and we want to hear how they are going to promote this Golconda Fort to tourists, make it more tourist friendly in future. Thank you.
Very good morning to all. Taking advantage of the esteemed presence of the dignitaries on the dais and off the dais, I would like to congratulate and appreciate the effort of Tourism Department, Telangana Tourism, and others who have like coordinated with this. So for me personally, I'm a biker. So when Chhatrapati approached me, I was so excited, and I thought it should happen here, and that too in Golconda, because personally I feel that there is no other way to see the whole world with rider bars in hand. So I feel in this way. I think you're all like support my view being a biker. So about Golconda, I don't want to say much about it, but we are all witnessing a historical moment, because such an event never happened in any of the monuments under the jurisdiction of Archaeological Survey of India. And that's the reason why I explain this as a historical event, and we look forward for such events in future with the cooperation of Tourism Department and Telangana Tourism, and of course Jai Bharati, Ms. Jai Bharati, and also motorcycle riding app Rev Your Soul. Because when I set up my travel in 2014, unfortunately there were no apps during that period, and our only personal app was Mr. H.V. Kumar, who used to give guidelines during our travel and all. So I thank you so much, India Tourism, for organizing such a beautiful event in the Golconda premises, and we wish to have more events like this in future. Thank you so much.
I'll go to Mr. Srinivas today, asking him the do's and don'ts the bikers should do on the road about road safety and how to ride responsibly. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, madam. Respected dignitaries on the dais and riders and other who are present here, wishes from our transport department. First, I want to ask one question. Which is the profession needs more attention in this world? Which profession?
Police.
Driver. Because every fraction of a second the scene changes. Suppose if you take a police, he will have some time to take decision, right? Doctor also he has time to take decision. So many days, months, they will keep on lifeline to take decision. But driver, they don't have any chance. If a fraction of second misses, he doesn't have any chance. So always you should be alert on the road. That is the first and most prioritized act when you come onto the road. Not only for driver, even as a pedestrian also, you should be very careful on the road. I think 1-2 years back, when Harley Davidson driver, he lost his life near Kamareddy checkpost. Really, it was a very unfortunate incident. I was traveling on that road that day. He is riding on his part, but other motorcyclist, he is taking U-turn at the gap in median. Unfortunately, he hit the driver, that motorcycle, and they fell down. Both of them lost their lives. So yesterday, in one accident, 3 people died. Can you expect that in 2 motorcycles collided each other? 3 people died on the spot. Can we expect this for a motorcycle accident? Suppose if it is a car or something, you will expect 2 or 3 members. But 2 motorcyclists collision, 3 people died on the spot near in Mancherial district. So I request, first, before riding, we need to learn all the safety and rules and regulations and safety tips to be safe on the road for ourselves and keep others safe. First, what happens now when we generally when we purchase any article or something, directly we will open it and put into use. But whereas in developed countries, they don't put it in use. First, they will read the what they will do? They will read manual. First, we have to read the manual, its operation, and its safety tips. Everything will be given in the manual. So please read the manual before using any bike or vehicle. What happened in one accident, one sub-inspector of police, he wanted to go for lunch. Generally he uses some, I don't know which brand, but in different brands they have different gear positions, right? So while coming back, he wanted to speed up, but he changed the gear, it went into low gear. Suddenly the following vehicle ran over him. So this is because of he doesn't have full knowledge about the controls. Sometimes what happens, you know, in a fraction of a second, we will search for a indicator or something. Few vehicles, they will have left side, few vehicles have right side. Sometimes to switch on the headlight, we will search for it. In that fraction of a second, the accident will happen. So one best example I will tell you. All of you are riders or drivers. Suppose think that you are driving a car with 100 kilometers per hour speed. What speed? 100 kilometers per hour speed. Suddenly you have seen one object or one person on the road. What do you think immediately? You want to slow down, right? What is your action? Immediately you will not apply brake. Immediately you will not apply brake, right? Yes, you will remove your foot from clutch and you will keep it on brake pedal. By this time, at least 1 to 1.5 seconds happens. 100 kilometers per hour vehicle, it goes around 30 meters distance. You have not done anything. The vehicle travel 30 meters. Just you removed your foot from accelerator and kept on brake pedal. Now what you will do? You will press the brake, right? If you press the brake, is it stops suddenly? No. It takes another distance, at least 100 meters. So total distance is 130 meters. First distance is called thinking distance. Second distance is called braking distance. You need at least 130 meters to stop the vehicle. It means you have to observe that person or something. You have to see before 130 meters, then only you can avoid that accident. So that is the reason you should be always alert. I hope you will all, well, professionals, you will be always alert on the road. And when you are walking on the road, which side you will walk? Left side. As a rule, we will walk on the left side. Okay, when there is a footpath, it is safe to walk on left side. When there is no footpath, please walk on right side so that you can see the vehicles coming in opposite direction. What happens now when the vehicle loses control? You can take a defensive action and you can save yourself. So many accidents happen. If you walk on the left side, the vehicle comes from the back side and hits you and go. So please wear a reflective jacket or something when you are going in the from dusk to dawn on the road. If you don't have a reflective jacket, at least all we are having a smartphones, right? Just you switch on the camera, torch light, or otherwise you switch on the, just to open the screen so that other drivers can can see you and they can take preventive action. Otherwise, as we discussed earlier, if the driver cannot see you in advance, he cannot stop the vehicle. So he will hit and drag you to some distance. So please take precautions always. I am feeling proud because my son is also a rider. He always, every Sunday he goes, he is now in Pune. Every Sunday I will have a tension till he reaches home. So if I don't call in weekdays, at least I will call on Sunday evening whether he is safely reached at home or not. So please always ride safely and reach safely. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. And since we are going Facebook Live also, I guess many people are watching us and listening to, sir, what the police has to say about traffic safety. You are riding very good, but ride safely and ride responsibly. You shouldn't be a cause of worry to your family, to your friends and other commuters on the road. I would like to invite Anand, the representative of Radio Soul. Now, we would like to ask him how Radio Soul works and how it can be a friend to the bikers.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Good morning, distinguished guests on the dais, my friends, bikers and others who have joined us for this event. It's really nice to see all of you on this Sunday morning. It's actually difficult to wake up in the morning on Sunday because the only day you get to relax, and I'm really thankful for all of you to join us. Before I start, this idea came up and me and Jaibharti approached Shatrupa ma'am to collaborate with India Tourism. The idea being that now that the pandemic is in the decline stage is what I think. But I know the best way to travel as of now is on your own bikes. Even cars, unless you're traveling with your own family, I think cars are also not safe. So I think the best way to travel in India presently is using your own bike. So we came up with the idea saying, why not we collaborate or affiliate with India Tourism and Telangana Tourism? Because we are setting out on these rides through our app, and we can also promote tourism in our country. Like Jaibharti rightly pointed out, we're always looking to the other side of the globe to see that there are beautiful locations all over the world to explore, but we're actually forgetting what is there within our backyard. And that was the idea. I said, let us collaborate with India Tourism as well as Telangana Tourism. Firstly, we are a startup based out of Hyderabad. So we said the first thing, our affiliation and affinity towards our own state. So I said, first, let's collaborate with Telangana Tourism to promote the beautiful places they've actually made for us. We've been on rides to Somasila and much other places, which are less known to a lot of people within our state as well as in the country. So we started using our hashtags. So we started tagging Telangana Tourism to promote these lesser known destinations in Telangana. So to tell you about Revio Soul, it's a motorcycle riding app where you connect with bikers. The idea being, a lot of bikers actually don't know where to go. Like Smithavanam just pointed out that earlier there was no such avenue or no such platforms where actually you could interact with bikers and at least know or see where you want to go or take the guidance of somebody where you're going to. It was usually some person or individual that was already in the riding scene that they would collaborate with or talk to actually set out on these journeys. Well, it was also my experience that same thing I experienced since 2014 since I started riding, and I didn't have a platform where I could reach out to other bikers or meet other bikers. So usually bikers were secluded by the brand of bike they used to ride. Royal Enfield rider rides with Royal Enfields, Harley rides with a Harley, a Triumph rides with a Triumph. So your group is limited to your brand of bike as well as the territory you're actually living in. So if you're living in Hyderabad, you're restricted to Hyderabad. If you're living in high-tech city, you're restricted to high-tech city. So a lot of these bikers became very secluded by the number of brands or the clubs that came into being. So I said, how do I reach out to these brands? If I'm riding an RE, I can't actually ride with the Triumph, I can't ride with the Harley. I said, how can I do that? Because they're so tightly knit by the brand showrooms or the brand identities they create that they don't let anybody else come in. But like me, there were other bikers who wanted to ride, just have the passion for riding and just ride. We didn't care that it was an RE, it was a Harley or it was a Triumph. I said, it was a passion for riding that I've actually set out on this Revio Soul journey. I said, I want to reach out to bikers who have the same passion for riding. So what do bikers do? The idea of riding, I'm a lawyer by profession, and as a passion to get away from my legal profession, the times when I had to ease off my mind, I started riding. I picked up a sports bike and I started riding. But when I started riding, I said, okay, where do I go to? I need to go to places that mean something to me, that mean something to our culture, that mean something to our country. I said, okay, it's not just hitting the road and going wherever you can. It's about also realizing that you have a beautiful country, you have a beautiful place in our country. There are a lot of places which are unexplored. A lot of people go to the most popular destinations. So we came up with the idea to say, hey, first let's connect with bikers. Second thing, when we connect with the bikers, where do we go? So I gave the option for riders to create their own rides on the platform. So when they create their own rides, they're actually pinning the destinations or locations where they want to go. And this ride invite is sent to bikers all over India who are using our app. And once the invite is sent, it's your choice where you want to ride. So it may be in Hyderabad, may be in Pune, may be in Bangalore. And that was the idea, saying how do we go to different locations, different destinations. And that's how the idea of Reversal came about. Then the most important part of our app is safety, rider safety. And like Srinivas Garu rightly pointed out, riding is not easy. It's the most difficult job or profession on the planet. You have a fraction of a second to decide whether you want to, you live or you die. It's as simple as that. I've lost a lot of friends in riding, sir. And that's why it also came up, saying safety, promoting safety on the app is very important to us. So we came up with a lot of features in our app. We have a lot of SOS features where you can actually track your riders on the app. So if somebody is missing, you can actually track his GPS and see where he is, and you can reach out to him. Or if somebody is stranded somewhere, you can actually reach out to the others by sending out an SOS message, which also sends your GPS location. As well as you have access to emergency services like the ambulance services, roadside assistance, police, and hospital services. So it's directly on the click of a button. A lot of people actually in panic mode actually forget what are the actual numbers. If I actually, even me, it's not about any of you, a lot of people in panic mode will actually forget it's 100 for police, 108 for ambulance, 1033 for NHAI. A lot of people don't remember that at that moment, everybody's panicking. So when you're actually with the app, you at least know that this is rightly available to you. Even if you don't remember it at that point of time, you actually have access to it. So this is how we've actually integrated riding as a passion and riding to different destinations, making it an expedition to promote our country, our country's tourism, which I tell you, it's amazingly beautiful. There are a lot of places to visit on your bikes, and with the help of Shatrupa Madam and Telangana Tourism and the India Tourism Department, they're actually going to give us the locations which they have been developing, and they are the places which are not known to a lot of people in our country, and those rides or those places will be put on as rides on our platform. And then we set out on these rides to explore these beautiful places. And Madam has actually promised to help us reach those places and give us whatever support they can, as well as Telangana Tourism, who has extended their hand in our first event on the 2nd of Jan, where we had a Telangana Tourism Minister, Srinivas Gowda Garu, on the event. And he promised to help us explore and help us promote tourism in our state. So I take this opportunity to thank all of you for joining us, especially our guests who have graced this occasion. Smita Garu, thank you so much for giving us this location. I think it marks the beginning for Revere Soul. Absolutely, without Shatrupa Ma'am, this would have not been possible. Thank you so much. And the person who's always been pushing me to do things is Jai Bharati. So she's the one who said, let's do this with the India Tourism and Telangana Tourism. Thank you so much. And sir, we would like to actually thank you for coming. And also, we look forward to your support, continued support, to actually help promote Telangana Tourism, and we'd be glad to do it. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Actually, it is our duty to create a platform where everybody can come together. Where this because government is nothing without the public, without the people of our country. What is a government if our people is not participating, if we are not connected to our people? So here we have our private persons sharing our stage, and also we have ASI, we also have Telangana Tourism, we also have the police department. So our job is to create a platform for you where you can connect to each other. And that is what we are doing. So from here, Telangana Tourism has to take up, because they have these beautiful properties scattered all over Telangana, which are giving beautiful camping grounds where you can actually ride through, make your parking, do a camping, do an overnight stay, and then start off next day for a different destination. Recently, I have been to such a road trip to Ramappa, to Warangal, to Taduvai, to Bhopalpalli, and believe me, the properties are beautiful. They have got enough space, they have got very good accommodation for overnight campers, they can arrange bonfires, they can give you this camping experience, what you are looking for. So I'd like to ask
the representative from Telangana Tourism, Mr. Ajni Reddy, Anji Reddy. He will tell us what are the properties you can look at and what Telangana government can help you to achieve.
Thank you, ma'am.
Madam Das, Chhatrapati Jayabharti and Madam Smita and the Srimas sir and Arvind and all the guests, the bikers as well as invitees. Good morning, everybody. I am from Telangana Tourism. My name is Anji Reddy. I am a joint manager marketing. As Madam said, you know, Telangana Tourism is always there to help, not only bikers, everybody in adventure sports, whatever. And as second Anand was telling, minister is also promised to give full support whatever they want to the bikers. And you, most of the people must be knowing there are a lot of places to see in Telangana. You know, I think you might have been to so many places other part of the country, but lot of to see in Hyderabad, you know, in Telangana itself. Let's say just 80 kilometers from here, it's Anantagiri Hills. It's a beautiful place. And either summer resort we can say in Telangana, it's at least 2-3 degrees less than Hyderabad always. And it's very nearby. We have beautiful hotel also there, resort, with all facilities. About 40 rooms are there. You have a swimming pool, banquet restaurant, everything is there. And if you go to southern part of the state, Somasila, it's a beautiful place on the bank of river Krishna. It's about 200 kilometers from here. It's one of the beautiful place you can have a ride, because you have to go by your own vehicle only, because it's a interior Nagarkal district. It's a beautiful place on the bank of river Krishna, and there we can have the camping also during monsoon too. This February end you can enjoy there, and summer it's not easy, it's water will be very low. And if you go to eastern part, Nagarjuna Sagar, yeah, most of people must be knowing, we have beautiful guest house Nagarjuna Sagar. It's the oldest guest house I can say since the construction of the dam. And we have beautiful about 40-45 rooms are there, banquet halls there, swimming pool, bar and restaurant. And we have a beautiful, just like this, like a garden behind our hotel and a view with the dam. And you can have the camping, and even if you go in the winter, you can have put in a bonfire over there. You can stay in the rooms, lavish rooms are there, and everything you can rent there. And if you go towards northeast, you can say Warangal. The Warangal is the place, but you have 3-4 places are there beyond Warangal. Warangal is a Hanumakonda. If you go to Pakal, a beautiful lake, and we have a resort over there. If you go to beyond that, Ramappa Lake and Lucknowvaram. Lucknowvaram is very popular nowadays, I believe. We have constructed two suspension bridges, just putting on the, you know, keeping on the demand. We have water sports over there. We have couple of islands developed there. There are 7 to 8 islands are there totally. And initially we have developed 2 islands where you can stay there. It's beautiful, accommodation is there. So if you go there, you have to forget everything. Sometimes your mobile may not work there. You have to forget everything from your place, you can enjoy there. Yes, ma'am. Yes. And Lucknowvaram. If you find weekends, na, you never get any accommodation over there. You have to plan 1 month in advance. Otherwise, you will not get accommodation over there. And if you go to Thadwai, it's within the forest. We have constructed beautiful resort on the main road. The area is such a way that you can enjoy. If you wake up in the morning, you feel like, oh yes, I'm in a lovely place, because surrounding place is very lovely. It's on the main road, and beyond that is all Thadwai is the Thadwai. If you go to nearby is the Etur Nagar, is a wildlife. You can go wildlife. It's a huge forest is there. You can go inside the forest and you can trek everything. And after that, Godavari, beyond that, Bogada waterfalls. They're all sightseeing places, you know, we're all nearby to Thadwai, Ramappa. And Ramappa is a historical place. The big, huge lake is there. There also we constructed a hotel. And these are the hotel places. And if you go a little bit ahead towards Bhopalapalli, there is one Pandavala Guhalu. You might have seen that. It's a wonderful place. The rock formation is such a way that you may not imagine such a wonderful place. It's a Pandavala Guhalu, it's called. It's a natural formation of rocks. One must visit that. And if you go to other parts, you know, Kaleshwaram, it's a holy place. And there also we have constructed beautiful guest houses. Nowadays, you know, see, this Kaleshwaram, this water, this thing, all construction. You can visit the dam and pump houses, all the Kaleshwaram project you can see, which was developed by the government. And if you go to southern part, this is the northern part, the Janaram is a wildlife. Kaval Wildlife is there. And before that, Kadam is the reservoir. It is 30 kilometers from each places. And you can have beautiful camping sites at Kadam Reservoir and as well as in Jannaram village. And from Jannaram, you can go inside the forest. You can go the wild. You can visit the wildlife. You have a set up couple of jeeps over there. You can make use of them and you can see the forest wildlife there. And other parts, you know, like southern part Basra, Nizamabad, Ali Sagar. Ali Sagar is from Nizamabad. Nizamabad is 145 kilometers from Hyderabad. And again from there, 15 kilometers is Ali Sagar. It is also a beautiful location with a huge lake is there. On the bank of the lake, we have constructed a beautiful hotel. There also you can put up your camp and sites, everything. And again, 30 kilometers from there is Basra. Basra, you must be knowing the Saraswati temple. The one of the Saraswati temple in Telangana, maybe in South India, I believe. There also we have 40 rooms, hotel is there. And wherever you go, in Telangana, we have hotel there. And all the places are equipped with beautiful rooms, spacious rooms, and make use of them. And from our Telangana tourism, you know, if any groups, not only bikers and any groups are from associations, if they can approach us, we'll extend maximum discount to all facilities well in advance. And especially the bikers, you know, earlier also our secretary, when Venkatesham was there, Jayabharti must be knowing, they promoted their rally toward the southern other parts of the country also, other countries also. And like that, we are always there. Telangana tourism is always there to help you. Whenever you plan for your ride and your camping, let us know. We'll make you all the facilities and give you maximum discount possibly, and we'll make it success. And for giving this opportunity, thank you all.
Thank you so much. What more can we want? Telangana Tourism is always giving us a helping hand in whatever program we do in the state. And they are very tourist friendly and they have a beautiful website. Please go to the website of TSTDC and find out what are the properties and then plan your trip accordingly. Thank you so much for being with us. We learned from our distinguished guests and this is the time for a pledge. So I would ask Jay Bharti if she can lead us to a road safety pledge which the bikers should follow.
Join hands together. For making a better society and environment for the riders. Let us all pledge together to be responsible on roads while riding or driving and promise to share and spread awareness with others and make all feel comfortable and responsible. Now please repeat after me. I promise that I will ride responsibly. Thank you so much. Thank you.